One of those which the great architect of the universe is constantly pouring out through his system. Is constantly pouring out, constantly pouring out, constantly pouring out.
Half a sheep covering.
The arts of the Aetheria. The Aetheria.
Please take note and you will hopefully learn something. So I'm going to read from The Hidden Life in Freemasonry by Charles Leadbetter, and we're going to go to page 145. It's going to be about the chakras. So reading within here, the four centers exist as points of connection at which energy flows from one vehicle or body of a man to another. Anyone who possesses a slight degree of clairvoyance may easily see them in the etheric double, where they show themselves as saucer-like depressions or vortices in its surface. When quite undeveloped, they appear as small circles about 2 inches in diameter, glowing dully in the ordinary man. But when awakened and vivified, they appear as blazing, coruscating saucers much increased in size. We sometimes speak of them as roughly corresponding to certain physical organs. In reality, they show themselves at the surface of the etheric double, which projects slightly beyond the outline of the dense body. If we imagine ourselves to be looking straight down into the bell of a flower of the convolvulus type, we shall get some idea of the general appearance of a chakra. The stalk of the flower in each case springs from a point in the spine. So another view might show the spine as a central stem or tree from which flowers shoot forth at intervals, showing the openings of their bells at the surface of the etheric body. Now I am going to read on through here. We're just going to jump a couple of paragraphs though. When at all in action, these centers show signs of rapid rotation, and into each of their open mouths, notice the word mouth, terminology. Okay, so I'm going to interrupt the flow of reading here for a moment, and we're talking about the rotation of those chakras. Now you can see that within the cherubim-like figures in Kimber Lane in Sydney, and they have the third eye chakra there represented also, just in case there is any confusion. Now also within this Iron Man figure, you can also see that vortexual like configuration there. Now if you look at the cornucopia, you can see that sort of twisting also in various cornucopias. You can also see the foliage going through there also. So we're talking about a burst from the chakras, if you will, and then I would suggest another burst from that also. You can also see the foliage going through there.
You've got a lot to look at.
So anatomy, here's burst one, here's burst two. With all of these, you have an opening, whether it be the opening of the foliage or the opening of the mouth with the elemental flow through. It could be earth, air, fire, and water, for example, but these flow throughs from the mouth or just out. So another example here, the burst, first burst with the cornucopia, and then the second burst, as you can see on this Freemasonic building. These bursts, bursts, bursts. You can see it within the foliage in particular, but it comes out of the elemental mouths as well of the various interdimensional creatures.
We'll be right back.
When at all in action, these centers show signs of rapid rotation. 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 So do not differentiate between the lotus, the opening of the lotus as a portal way, and the mouth of, say, a dragon or a further elemental as a portal way also. Do not differentiate between the elemental creatures and the elemental tree of life represented by the foliage. Do not differ. Emergence from the foliage, just to add a bit more context. So you will see the tails with the foliage there. Emergence from the foliage, you see it over and over and over. The pillars of foliage, so emergence from the pillars. In Melbourne you have the genie sculpture there by Tom Bass, and the tail of it has that vortex to it. It's as if it's come out of something, emerged, metamorphosized out of the tree of life, out of these portals. Here you see the horse kind of integrating with that portal way. So the elemental creatures are like a manifestation out of the tree of life, if you will. When at all in action, these centers show signs of rapid rotation, and into each of their open mouths, notice the word mouth, terminology, and into each of their open mouths, at right angles to the surface of the body, there rushes a force from the higher world. One of those which the great architect of the universe is constantly pouring out through his system. That force is sevenfold in its nature, and all its forms operate in each of these centers, although one of them in each case greatly predominates over the others. And it goes on talking about this inrush of energy, and in a way it kind of comes out through the chakras. There rushes a force from the higher world. So according to Ledbetter, energies from the higher world via the great architect of the universe as per Freemasonry, these energies are coming through these portal systems and then out through the mage, out through the chakra system of the mage, the tubes and chakra system of the mage, and into the space around the mage where you'd have the auras or the tiled area, the etheric magnetic area of a greater ritual scenario. Now, with this particular depiction here, you have Yakshi, a nature spirit or mother goddess from India. And now, this entity may not necessarily be a human entity there. It may be a further entity also having an experience via this tree. So with the tree there, you can see the flowers around with the further sort of burst coming through them, like the fleur-de-lis. If you look carefully with this one, you can see that extra extension, that extra burst coming out yet still. And then if we look at Yakshi closely in this depiction around the legs in particular, you can see that similar configuration sort of coming out, that tree coming out of the body. And then it would be of no surprise when you go to Egypt, you can see the tree and the body kind of being melded into one, if you will. So going back to Yakshi from India, you can see at the forehead there, you can see the flower there. In this depiction, by the way, you can see the eye there, and I've got the depiction there from Louis Vuitton with the eye and the flower. But nevertheless, with Yakshi there, like sort of at the surface of the body, just the outer surface, you can see those flowers, and you get that depiction with your sort of superheroes as well, with the chakra represented at the surface of the body. of course, you get the flow through from the hands, an extension of the chakra once again. And of course, within the body, you would have that cross, the cross system, which of course would represent Christ on the cross with the cross of light. And they try to show you that over and over again. But so really, it's a cross of light rather than the hard wooden cross. And of course, Jesus has the holes in the hands and the feet. And you will see the flowers represented at both the hands, at the feet, particularly in Asia there. These are portal ways. So these portal ways are well represented in this depiction from South America. And also within Cirque du Soleil, the tree with the elemental sort of orbs going through that tree, if you will, through the body and here through the mage, and then out into the ritual edifice in this case, where manifestations happen. In this depiction, you can see the great architect actually in an orb as well. And you have a lot of that orb symbology, orbs coming through, but energies also, and manifestations and shifts, I would suggest, perhaps created by different energies from different places. But that's a big subject. Within RuneScape, of course, there's a similar thing depicted with Cirque du Soleil, with the energy coming out from the chakra region. But I hope you enjoyed this video with these kind of bursts, with this flow, whether it's from the foliage or whether it's from the mouth, with earth, air, fire, and water. And then, of course, your in-betweens, your alchemy in between all that. I'll leave it at this, and goodbye for now.